Hello, everyone. Are you tired of playing the same songs and just okay? You know what? I don't want to do the same joke again. If you're watching this, you probably don't know how to install DLCs, and you were too late to the party. Note for this tutorial and the greatest hits tutorial, I would recommend for legal purposes, I would recommend doing it legally if you can, but there's no legal way to do it, so for legal reasons, I have to say I do not endorse this behavior, but for the sake of this video, let's just assume you don't have any DLCs, and this happens. Yeah. Also, for this video and the greatest hits video, I'm only covering the Wii version because it's the only version I have, one for one. And also, if you wanted a PlayStation or Xbox version of this, why'd you come to a channel that mostly focuses on Nintendo content? I mean, like, the only Xbox games I play are Battlefront and It Takes Two, and probably some other games like whatever this one is. Say I don't play Xbox a lot, especially compared to Wii and Switch. But you're here because you want DLCs, but this happened. Oh. Because the connection is no longer in service, and this song list just feels incomplete without DLCs for whatever reason. I don't know. I'm gonna tell you how to get Just Dance DLCs. This will work for Guitar Hero 5 and Guitar Hero Warriors Rock as well. And it will also work for Rock Band 3. So, yippee. Although with Rock Band 3, you have to wait freaking forever to play the DLCs. But for the sake of this video, we're going to be playing Just Dance. And, yeah. For legal reasons, I can't say I endorse this. But for video purposes, if this is your only method, then go right on ahead. I can't stop you. Here we go. So, previously, we learned how to install the Greatest Hits mod, which is not gonna work with Just Dance 3, and trust me, if it did, there would be overlap. You can download it from here, which, yeah, I'll probably just link this in the description, because, yeah. You can get whatever songs you want from here, or you can go into here. You can go into Big Wads, and bam, you got all sorts of things. Like, you got Band Hero, who plays Band Hero. You got Rock Band. You got Guitar Hero, and there's a whole bunch of Guitar Hero. And there's Just Dance, and some more Rock Band at the bottom. It's important to pay attention to which one you're getting. If you're in the USA, you want to get the USA version. If you're in Europe, you want to get the Europe version. Well, thank goodness you don't have to see me downloading a whole bunch of these WADs. So you can just close that out and for this one, we're going into this PC. A whole bunch of things. WADs, Just Dance 2. Since I have a USA copy of the game, I'll be using USA hardware. So yeah. Which means you want to take, it's a lot easier when you have two of these items. So we're going to go to downwards, and then we're going to have a whole bunch of Wattabin stuff, and, yeah, we're only going to showcase Just Dance 2, 3, and 4, because, let's be honest, it's a lot easier to get Just Dance 3 DLC working than it is Just Dance 2014 DLC working, if I'm being honest. So, here we have Guitar Hero content here. I'm separating these from each other because it's just easier that way. So now what you want to do is take Just Dance 2, 3, and 4's DLC. You can put them here, and then what you want to do is... So you want to download Reconnect Patcher, which I have a whole lot of Clone Hero charts. A lot of which are official Guitar Hero charts that are hard or I cannot play. And also some Rock Band charts as well. It's a bunch of which are just there for me to see what's behind big rock endings. So what you want to do is, you want to enter one. So yeah, you want to be careful what you choose. If you're playing on the Wii, you'll be selecting 1. If you're playing on the Wii U, you'll be selecting 2. If you're playing this on Dolphin, which I'm not, I'm playing on the Wii, I'm going to choose 1. If you're playing on Dolphin emulator, you want to choose 3. So yeah, select your number and then, yeah. There's noises here as well. Of which they probably come from Legend of Zelda or something. So yeah, you want to select 3 unless you want to do some other stuff. So choose 3 unless you want to do something else. You will also want to have... You also want to have your... Wii stuff dumped to your SD card, but since I already have that, I always have to do this like 50% of the time. Select your SD card letter, which you can get by just going to this PC and seeing what letter appears in the parentheses before the colon. Which I probably shouldn't be showing, but this is for educational purposes. And then you want to install WAD files to your SD card by selecting 1 again. And then your Wattabin stuff should be within the downloads, right? Here, you can see, I have the WAD files for Just Dance 4, 3, and 2. Oh, wait, it's in reverse alphabetical order. Not alphabetical, reverse numerical order because of the way my computer works. But it shouldn't matter too much because we can just start installing these. I'm going to cut down the time because, yeah. So yeah, once you get all the WAD files you want, you can just install them all in. Yeah, it'll probably take forever. Just to install 3 of them, it'll probably take a while. And if you're installing Rock Band DLC, holy moly, will it take forever. So, we're installing Just Dance DLCs, and you can see that I'm using the big WAD files because... Dramatic effect. While we're waiting for all the DLCs to get installed and stuff, we're gonna go ahead and, yeah, Just Dance 3 Target Edition. You will need Just Dance 3 in the disc slot. I'm using Target Edition because it has Airplanes and Only Girl in the World, and I do not have Best Buy Edition, actually. And... Yeah, you want homebrew. Again. One thing to note, I don't think the Greatest Hits mod will work on the Wii. So no, you cannot play Heart of Glass in Just Dance 3 unless you're playing on Xbox. But even then, I don't know how to install Xbox DLCs. So if you want to see what Heart of Glass would look like in the Just Dance 3 style, get the Greatest Hits mod and follow the tutorial for that if you don't know how to install it for whatever reason. You can see nothing's here because the SD card is still plugged into my computer, and yeah. While we're here, though, I might as well show you some pictures that I have. Take a look at this photo. Urge to Game viewers will... Urge to Game people in the Urge to Game Discord will be able to see that this was a thing. So is this, and this. Oh my gosh, that smile is kind of creepy, though. And, yeah. Four Corners, 2024, all that stuff. This bar sub was from a competition between my brother and I. It's black screen. This is a really difficult thing to get in 6 puzzle pieces, so you can't see anything. It's a cool challenge, but yeah. And we got a CD also from the competition. And then this. And we have this thing which transparent pixels don't show, apparently. This is supposed to be an invasion of transparency. Investigation time. And yeah. Okay, so once all the DLC is downloaded, you will be able to eject your SD card with no consequences. I make sure to eject it before removing it, so that it doesn't get damaged. So the next step you want to do is insert the SD card back into your Wii. And then, once you have your SD card in, launch Homebrew. And then, you will want to open up Wii Mod Lite. I'm gonna ask you to be extremely careful. You could potentially, if you mess up, you could potentially lose everything in terms of safes. So I'm gonna ask you again, be careful. So anyways, you're gonna wanna install these WADs. One at a time is probably better when you have a bajillion things. And yeah. You don't want to. Yeah. What you want to do is go back to your stuff. Yeah. When you end up finishing Wii Mod Lite, you can go back to your Wii menu and then. Yeah. Alright. What do you want to do? Open up Just Dance 3. Open up whatever Just Dance game you got the DLCs for. And once it starts, which probably will. Now, it should say scanning SD card for content if you're playing Just Dance 3, which will always happen if you have an SD card in, but if it takes longer than usual, then congratulations, it worked. Yay, it worked, and it froze. But don't worry, the game hasn't crashed yet. Now you will see a spinning disc right here. Go to it and bam! A song that isn't even in the game unless you got the DLC. And bam! A whole bunch of songs that are actually kind of a bunch of retro songs here. Why oh why was stupid to get 5 stars on in Just Dance 2 especially. But hey, look! Original Just Dance 3 content! And also some PS3 exclusives. No longer exclusive to PS3. Bam, take that, PlayStation players. I can outplay the same maps you do. What about Just Dance 4? What about Just Dance 4, you might be wondering? How will that work? Well, I'm glad you asked. Because so yeah, once Just Dance 4 lights up, you can enter Just Dance mode, and then this should take longer than usual. If it worked, at least. Yeah, hey, it probably worked. Don't worry about it freezing unless it actually crashed and you hear the noise. And then, if everything worked correctly, bam, DLC! And they're all playable, and hold up, I got the American version. Why in the world is the same song appearing twice in a row? Not in a row, but why does it appear twice? Anyways, yeah, look, I got a whole leaderboard of 5-star scores on this song. Honestly, this definitely got some really good DLC here. I'll be honest. When you're playing these songs for the first time, be wary of the game crashing, because that can and probably will happen. Especially if you got, like, a whole bunch of DLCs like I do. Like, if you got more than 3 DLCs, it's very likely that your game will crash at least once. Well, like, if you played on the DLCs once before, you probably won't have to worry about crashes again, but, I mean, it can still happen, so don't say I didn't warn ya. Just don't say I didn't warn ya, okay? Okay, so you might be wondering, what about Just Dance 2, huh? What about Just Dance 2? Well, if you want to have a guarantee, you will need homebrew again. I know, lame. Yeah, you're probably gonna need homebrew again. What you wanna do is load up USB Loader GX. If you wanna play Just Dance 2 DLC, this is the safest way to do it. Firework is the only song that doesn't require it and still be DLC from my testing. But it could be because I played it a couple times. All you want to do is, for the game split size, split each 2 GB, and, I think I have iOS 58 loader settings. iOS 58, yeah, iOS 58 should work. These are all games you can play from the... These are all either games or applications you can load straight from the Wii menu, because... Well, I'm lame like that. What you want to do after changing the settings like that, you will want to click on the disc icon and then play Just Dance 2. You'll see a play counter as at 4. And that's not because I only played it 4 times ever. I only played it 4 times while in homebrew. all the gameplays before those four times were from when I didn't have access to the DLC from 2020 all the way to 2023. Didn't have access to the DLC. When I did get access to the DLC, I couldn't load it. And you can see here I got golden because I got all 5 stars on every song in the base game. And then I got 5 stars on all the DLC because I'm just built different. No, but seriously, I just got good at the game. That's what happened. So if you got DLCs at all, it should do this. Don't be surprised. Although if you didn't do it with Homebrew, it's very likely these songs will get you a black screen of death. Why it took forever to get 5 stars on. But now that I got 5 stars on it, it looks like I didn't struggle at all getting 5 stars on it. Like, it looks like I got harder time with It's Not Unusual than YOY, even though It's Not Unusual, I got 5 stars on my first try. Yeah, some of these songs I got a couple attempts on, but most of these DLC songs I didn't want to try. But if you want to see it working with Homebrew, just look at this. Look at all these DLC songs. These DLC songs will appear without Homebrew, but you need Homebrew to actually play them. So with Homebrew, you can play a random song. It's Not Unusual. Why not? Here. Yeah. If it works, it should be able to load like this. And not give you a black screen of death after like a couple frames of that loading screen appearing in. Look. It works. I'm not doing this one-handed. I did try it with some scores saved, but it still would give me a black screen of death. But after a couple songs have been played, you're probably gonna see this, the DLC thing again, so be aware of it, I guess. 2 minutes and 58 seconds? Is that short? There's a whole lot packed into 2 minutes and 58 seconds then. With Crazy Christmas, because of how things are rendered in the game, this border will also be here, which actually is the only song I think that does that, which is cool and all, but like, yeah. But I never played Should I Stay or Should I Go, so I can't say for sure, but this song might actually be the only one that does it. Yeah, you can see a whole bunch of stuff. Yeah, you get the point, right? You get the point. It works. Everything works. Yeah. Whole bunch of songs work, and yeah. You will need Homebrew for Just Dance 2, though. Yeah. If you see this after 2 songs have been played, don't be surprised. But, also not saying that you shouldn't expect it. Not saying that you should always expect it, but don't be surprised if it appears after every 2 songs. Because that's how it worked for me. Yeah. Also, you know, I wanted to sort it. Also, alphabetical works with the DLC songs included. Like, they just fit right in seamlessly. All the sorting systems work properly. I just have to sort it alphabetically because I know the Japanese games don't sort it alphabetically like they claim to. Which is very confusing. But oh well, they probably won't know unless they know how the alphabet works. Yeah, the fact of the matter is the DLCs fit seamlessly into pretty much all sorting systems, and they don't feel out of place, they don't feel separated, they don't feel alienated. You can even look at archives and it will freeze for a moment, but don't worry, the game hasn't crashed yet. And, yeah, 5 entire pages of DLC. So, yay, I showed you how to install DLCs, and I'm gonna clear up a couple questions. Does the Greatest Hits work? Does the Greatest Hits mod work with Just Dance 3? No. And if you are like, well, you're playing Target Edition. Fine then. No. No, it doesn't. I think I'll show you right now that this DLC will work with all versions of Just Dance 3. So that it doesn't seem like it's Target exclusive, because it's not. This is the version I don't play as often. Oh. Well, that's unusual. Okay, maybe it is Target exclusive, but yeah, you get the point. Oh well, someone's willing to prove that I'm wrong somehow, and they can go right on ahead. But, fact of the matter, maybe it's because I reloaded it from Revolution. Because that seems to not always work, for whatever reason. That might, loading it from Revolution might cause unintended side effects. So, yeah. Yeah, DLC might be kind of a weird thing. So, yeah. DLC probably isn't that readable with Revolution. I'm just testing the regular version because I played Target Edition so much. Ooh. I wonder if that actually worked. That actually worked, holy moly. I played Target Edition so much that seeing the regular version of DLC is actually kind of good. So yeah, that's proof that DLC works in every version of Just Dance 3. Even though I only showed it working in two versions. So I got a whole bunch of songs. This one's never played in this version. Whole bunch of stuff. Yay, now we can see, now I can immortalize this new icon forever. But yeah, DLC works in this game, in the regular version as well, so all you people can play Boomsday now. Or even, I don't know, Cardiac Caris. Or maybe you all want to play Merengue. Just maybe. Okay, that was a joke. Obviously, you all want to play. Obviously, you all want to play Baby Don't Stop Now and Twist and Shake and Soul Searching. And Jumbo Mambo. Alright, so yeah, that's the entire video. Hope you enjoyed this, very entertaining video that is, I have to say this again, for legal reasons, I do not endorse this. But if this is the only method in which you can play it, then be my guest, do it. There's nothing I can do to stop you, but I just gotta say, I will probably never endorse this in terms of a legal setting, but I mean, who am I to stop you? I'm not a legal person. I'm not someone who's into legality and stuff. And, yeah. I mean, what does it look like I do? Become a lawyer? Is that what you think I do? I'm not a lawyer, so I can't say for sure that this is illegal activity that is being shown, but if this is the only way you can play Just Dance 3 DLCs, then so be it. I'm just gonna say it right now. I am not liable. You are, because you decided to follow this tutorial. So, you deciding to follow this tutorial is just your fault if you get into legal trouble. Because, well, we all know Ubisoft. They certainly don't like us playing older games, and they certainly don't like preservation, so if Ubisoft comes after you, I didn't tell you anything, okay? If Ubisoft comes after you for whatever stupid reason. But if for some reason you have a friend who wants to get Just Dance DLC but just doesn't know how to, then I guess show them this video, but tell them that I am not responsible for any legal troubles. And same thing with the Greatest Hits mod, I am not responsible for any legal troubles, okay? That you decided to do it. You decided to follow the tutorial, okay? You decided to do it. You decided to follow it, so. Okay? I know Ubisoft's probably really mad at me for modding their game, and now I'm showing them how to get DLC without actually getting the DLC legally. But you can't get it from their official stores anymore, so this tutorial will show you how to do it without going to the store, which I'm not sure that it is legal, but if it's not legal, then don't blame me, because you decided to follow this tutorial. Yes, I know I did it as well, but it was for educational purposes and what you shouldn't legally do if you're intending to always follow the law, like a perfect guy you are. Okay? I just have to say this. If you decide to follow this tutorial because
Well, if you decided to follow this tutorial, it's your fault for following this, okay? That's all I can say. I do not have control over your actions, but I do have control over whether or not you know of this tutorial. And I do have knowledge that you have the knowledge to see this tutorial and decide that you wanted to follow it.